A mat is used to hide part of one layer in After Effects using another layer. They are essential for working with texture, reveals, and compositing, and understanding exactly how they work will open up a world of possibilities for your animation and filmmaking. So to start, we need two layers. One is our base footage layer that we want to hide a part of, and the second layer is the actual mat. So to use it as a track mat, our mat layer has to be directly on top of our footage in the layer stack. Then we need to select the bottom layer, and from the track mat column, we need to select how we want to use this track mat. Now, if you don't see this column in your timeline, you can toggle it on and off down here with this icon in the bottom left. So there are two types of track mats that we can use, alpha mats and luma mats. First, let's select alpha mat and see what happens. We get our footage cut out in the shape of our head. And in our layer stack, we can see that our mat layer visibility has been turned off automatically. So we are no longer seeing our mat. We're seeing its shape and everything else has erased the footage underneath. And we can do anything to animate this layer independently. Let's quickly animate its position, its scale, and rotation. So now our mat is animated, but our footage is staying still. If we want our footage to stick to the mat, we need to select our footage layer, and then in the parent and link area, select the pick whip, click, drag, and release over our mat layer. Now when we play it, its scale, position, and rotation all move along with our mat. Now this track mat is called alpha mat because it is using the alpha channel of our image to determine what areas to cut out. And the alpha channel is essentially what part of this layer is transparent. So our head is a square PNG. I cut everything that's not his head out in Photoshop. So the pixels on the outside are transparent. After Effects sees that and only cuts out the visible pixels on our layer below. We can also choose alpha inverted mat, which essentially just inverts the alpha channel and flips what is visible and what is not. If you use this same principle on some text as an alpha mat over some footage, you can get this effect to transition from some text to your scene, like they do at the beginning of Stranger Things. Now let's see what happens when we use a luma mat. This is a little more interesting. Some parts of the head are removed from the layer underneath, but not all of it. Now After Effects isn't looking at the alpha channel, the transparency of the mat, it is looking at the luma channel, the luminosity values of this layer, which is its brightness, how light or dark it is. So the dark areas of this image, which would be the hair and the shadows, those are cut out of our footage. So only the bright areas of our mat remain in our footage below. And we can make adjustments to this. We can add an effect like curves to our mat layer and make it lighter or darker to change how much of our image below is revealed. And if we use luma mat inverted, that flips it again. So now it's removing the bright areas of our mat from our footage. If you find some footage of some bleeding ink, make it a track mat of your footage and set to luma mat inverted, and now you've got a nice ink reveal. Now the main disadvantage of using a track mat is that you can only use one mat. So if we wanted to cut out more than one shape from this layer, we would need to either pre-comp these layers and then use another alpha mat on that pre-comp, or pre-comp both of our mat layers and use that combination mat pre-comp as a track mat. Which either way isn't a very elegant solution, but know that it's there, and sometimes to get the effect you want, you'll have to brute force it by pre-comping some elements. In many cases though, the most elegant solution is to use the effect Setmat. Now to explain the Setmat effect, we are going to start in a fresh comp again with our rainforest footage, but we're gonna drag in a new mat to try. And this time we're gonna select our footage, and from the effects and presets panel, we are going to add the effect Set Mat. And up here in the effects control panel, we have many, many lovely options. We can choose which layer we want to take as a mat. We can choose whether we want to take the source of that layer or its masks, effects, and masks. And we can choose whether to use the alpha channel, the luminous channel, and a bunch of other channels as well, and options to invert it as well. So let's choose our matte LeBlanc layer, and we can see that's not doing quite what we'd expect. It's stretched out our matte layer. And this can happen a lot with the set matte effect. This is the main disadvantage of using it. In this case, we can simply uncheck the stretch matte to fit option, and now it's working like we'd expect. But our matte layer is still visible, so let's hide that. And now we can see the effect we want. And that is one of the benefits of the set matte effect. Our matte layer doesn't need to be on top of our footage layer. We can drag that underneath, turn it back on, and still use this layer for all sorts of things. We can even invert matte in the set matte effect and use the matte created to reveal the matte itself.
How are you doing?
And one thing you should definitely be aware of when using the set matte effect is how to deal with another common error you're likely to encounter. And that's when using a matte that has been pre-comped. So let's delete our matte layer here and drag in a composition which contains a few images. Let's go back to the set matte effect on our rainforest, change that to the new pre-comp, and you'll notice wherever I move the matte composition, the matte on our footage isn't following. So what we need to do in this circumstance is collapse transformations. And you can do that by selecting it down here in the timeline. And then of course we'll need to hide our matte comp. And now we can move our matte layer and it cuts out like we'd expect. So if your Setmat effect isn't working like you'd expect, double check to make sure stretch mat to fit is not selected. And then if using a comp or a layer that can be collapsed, make sure that is selected for both layers, the mat and your footage layer. To learn more really cool techniques with mats using textures, check out this next video where I make this animation. I'll see you there.